morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning to all. So we have been in the discussion of patterns in the last class. So we'll go through what we discussed in the previous class, and further we will continue. So here we were discussing about the field pattern, and as you have studied already regarding patterns and all, you have studied different types of patterns, field pattern and power pattern. And in that, we have also seen both the patterns in detail as well, and where you have also understood that there will be a main lob, side lobs, back lobs, and all those features, and it is a graphical representation. So further moving on to that field pattern, we can say that we are going to see everything with respect to the point sources. And point sources has electric field and magnetic field, and we have to deal with the far field. So the electric field and magnetic field are entirely transverse to the wave direction, all these things and perpendicular to each other. These things we had discussed in the previous class. And the ratio of E by H, that is equal to Z, and that will be 377 ohm. So when you go ahead further and see that the point sources everywhere, it is radial, and the field is entirely transverse, having E theta and E phi. And this is the figure which we have discussed. The theta component is here, and the phi component, you can see it is varying in this particular direction. So all these things is what we discussed in the previous class, and now we are going to see further how to go ahead with the rest of the concepts of the field pattern. So when you understand this, the two components are there, that is E theta and E phi, and those things we have also understood, and we are going to go ahead with the condition characterizing the far field. So there are two main conditions. These are all few theory concepts and equations. So there are two conditions which are characterizing the far field. The first condition is the pointing vector is radial, that is SR component. And the next one is electric field is transverse, that is E theta and E phi component. So we have seen that the theta and phi components are transverse to each other. The electric field is transverse, and the pointing vector is radial. So the component SR, we have also seen that SR can be written in terms of E, as SR is equal to 1 by 2 E square divided by 2. And Z naught you have already studied before, it is called as the intrinsic impedance of the medium, and we are here studying all about the concepts is all about the power pattern, field pattern, and where in the field pattern you can see that E can be defined as SR component is E square by Z, 1 by 2 E square by Z, where E can be defined as the component of theta and phi. So both the components of theta and phi, you can write it as root of E theta square plus E phi square. So these are few more equations you can just add on to that pattern, that is the field pattern. So you can see the conditions: pointing vector is radial, electric field is transverse, SR is 1 by 2 E square divided by Z, and Z naught is called as the intrinsic impedance. E is in E theta, it is both the combination of E theta and E phi. So it is root of E theta square plus E phi square. So E denotes the amplitude of the total electric field intensity. E theta denotes the amplitude of the theta component, and E phi is the amplitude of the phi component. So these are the three things. See all these terms we have already understood in the previous module itself. That concepts what you have understood in the pattern. So you have to merge with this as well. So when you write, you can add these points as well. If the pattern is asked, or the field pattern, or power pattern, anything which is asked for you, you can add these points as well. So make a note of these things. You have two equations, SR and E, and amplitude of the total electric field is found by taking the root of E theta square plus E phi square. Completed. So the pattern which is showing the variations of electric field intensity, the pattern will studying about the field pattern. So the pattern which is showing the variations of electric field intensity at a constant radius r as a function of angle theta and phi is called the field pattern. A definition you can say for the field pattern: the pattern which is showing the variations of the electric field intensity at a constant radius r as a function of theta and phi is called as the field pattern. So the field intensity, it is expressed in its unit is like volts per meter. Field intensity is expressed in volts per meter, is an absolute field pattern. And what you can understand here is the field pattern can be defined as the pattern showing the variations of the electric field intensity at a constant radius r as a function of angle theta and phi is called as the field pattern. So the field intensity unit can be written as volts per meter. So you can note down those points. So what you can see further is if the field intensity is expressed in units related to the value in some reference direction in the relative field pattern. So if you are mentioning the field intensity in units relative to the value in some reference direction, then it is called as the relative field pattern. So these things you should understand. And the reference direction is taken in the direction of maximum field intensity. So relative field pattern can be defined as of E theta is, it is always you have to divide by its maximum value. So we were doing it before as well. So what you are to find out the relative field pattern, you have to divide by its maximum value. So it is E theta divided by E theta m. So make a note of all these things. So you understood here that you can write the definition for pattern as pattern showing the variations of electric field intensity at a constant radius r as a function of angle theta and phi is called the field pattern. And the field intensity expressed in volts per meter is an absolute field pattern. And the relative field pattern can be written by dividing with its maximum value, that is E theta divided by E theta m. So make a note of these points, then we will go to the next part. So today I'll be discussing a very important thing, that is arrays of two isotropic points sources of same amplitude and phase. So those things will be, there will be five cases The first case I want all of you to listen carefully. The second case is modifications of further small changes. So it will be easy for you to understand if you understand the first case. Rest of the four cases are very much similar to the first case. So all of you have completed till here. Let us move further.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we understood here the definition for pattern. We understood here the relative pattern also and all these things. So further on, we will discuss on the relative field pattern for theta. You have already written. If you write for phi, it can be written as E phi divided by E phi m. That is the maximum value. So E phi m is called as the maximum value of E phi m is maximum value of E phi, and d theta m is maximum value of E theta. So if you want to find out the relative pattern, either it is for E theta or E phi, you have to divide with its maximum value. So we have SRM. So we have SRM can be written as EM square divided by 2Z. EM is the maximum value of E. So the relative total power pattern. So what you can write, the relative total power pattern is denoted as PN. The relative relative total power pattern is equal to the square of the relative total field pattern. So PN can be written as SR divided by SRM, and you can write U divided by UM, that is equal to E by EM whole square. So any of the equations you can use in order to define the relative total power pattern. It can be written in terms of SR. It is SR divided by its maximum value SRM. If you are writing it U divided by its maximum value UM, or if you are writing with field, you have to write with E divided by its maximum value whole square, you have to write. So you can see that we have already defined that power pattern is with respect to the field pattern. So we have understood the relationship between the power pattern and the field pattern. So you know that the power pattern is equal to square of the field pattern. So those things we have discussed in the patterns as well. So you can make a note of these things. And one more concept is phase pattern. So I want all of you to just go through the textbook and learn the phase pattern. It is just one paragraph. Just understand what is phase pattern. So you can put phase pattern and leave some space. So phase pattern, you note down some one paragraph and one figure. It is there. You can just draw that figure. You go through the textbook. I want you to go through the textbook. It is John D. Cross antennas. You can just go through that textbook. So I think it is third textbook in the syllabus. So all of you, leave some space for half a page is enough for phase pattern. You can make a note of some important points of phase pattern, and one figure is there where it represents the phase representation of the pattern, and that figure you can draw it there. So it won't come more than 2 to 3 marks. So 3 marks, some points you can mention it there for phase pattern. So later on, we will just go through the arrays of two isotropic point sources. Have you all completed this till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so all of you market very important, very, very important. That is the arrays of two isotropic point sources. It's a very important topic, and it is repeatedly asked in all the universities question papers. In this, we have five cases. So it is like they ask sometimes case one, sometimes case two or case three. But it is usually a important question for any of the examinations you write, that array of two isotropic point sources. And if it comes, means it will give you 10 marks easily. So it is not a difficult topic. It is very easy. And we have only around 5 to 6 equations and few concepts to understand here. And once you understand the case one, then it is a minor changes for case two and case three. So it is like it's very important for any university point of view, question papers or everything. And you can say that now, since we are in module four, it is all the process of antennas and all we are discussing now. CO4, that is we are understanding how the design of an antenna, what are the parameters related to the antenna design, all those things. We are going with course outcome 4, and with respect to the knowledge level is concerned, we will be always in K3 or K4 for this subject. So that is either apply or analyze. So we'll be just seeing this. I think all of you might have completed. So write down this, so leave some space for phase pattern, few points, some 5 to 7 points, and one small figure, you can put it there. So let us discuss on array of two isotropic point sources. Mark it as very important, the five cases involving two isotropic point sources. The first case, let me just go with the first case. Mark it as important, all of you. Here, all the five cases are important, and in that first and second case is very important. That is sometimes they used to ask here. The mistake what students really do is, it is very minor change you can see between the first and second case. So when they don't read the question paper of the university or internal question papers, instead of case one, they write case two, and vice versa. So case two is asked, they write case one. So even though the answer is correct, but it is not relevant to that question, so you lose the marks entirely. And so you read the question carefully when it comes for these cases, and it will be very minor changes. Like you can see here, case one will be two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase. So here it will be same amplitude and phase. If you just, I will take you to case two, where you can see that two isotropic point sources of same amplitude but opposite phase. Only this is the difference here. So if you don't read the question carefully, you write a different answer for that. So you should read the question carefully. Don't get confused with the case one or case two. So the first case what you are going to study here is two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase. So you have to think here that we are considering two isotropic point sources. So till now you have studied the power pattern, field pattern, then you have also studied the phase pattern, then you have understood this power theorem, and we also have discussed about an isotropic point source. So here in this module 4, we are discussing about the point sources. So point sources can radiate in all the 360 degree angle, and where it can have a complete efficiency of 100%. So that's what we have seen in the beginning. And now we are going to have two isotropic point sources. Two isotropic point source means, instead of considering one point source, we are considering two point sources. So here you may have point source one, and you will have point source two. So further on, one or two equations we'll study for n isotropic point sources, means you are keeping point source 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that till n. So n can be any number. So that is what we'll be studying further on in this module. So let us first go with two isotropic point sources. So we are studying here the array of two isotropic point sources. Case one is two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase. So here, as I have told you, let the two point sources be 1 and 2. So we are taking one point source here, another point source here. So till now we were studying about only single point source. Now we are considering two point sources. So what they are saying here is two isotropic point sources of same amplitude. So they are saying that two point sources are having same amplitude and phase as well, it is same. So it is one and two is almost the same. So two isotropic point sources with same amplitude and phase. So both are having same amplitude and same phase. So that's what you should be very careful in examination, whether it is asked for case one or case two or case three. So that is only the mistake what students make, but you read the question properly, you will not do that. So let the two point sources 1 and 2 are separated by a distance d and located symmetrically with respect to the origin of the coordinators. So what we are going to see here is we have an x axis and y axis. So on the x axis we are placing two point sources because we are going with two isotropic point sources. So one source is kept here, another source is kept at the other side, and you can see that the entire distance between the two sources is d. So d is the distance between the source 1 and source 2. So you can also see that if you take from the center, it is d by 2 towards the source 1 and d by 2 towards the source 2. So you have an array axis. This axis, you listen carefully, because how the first case is there, I have told you the other cases are almost similar to the first case. So listen carefully the first case. So you have an array axis. This axis is called as the array axis, the entire axis, okay? This entire thing is called as the array axis. So you can also see here when you are taking a it is already told that we are taking same amplitude and phase, and we are just taking r here, which is going towards a distinct point. Means you are taking to a longer distinct point where the r is to be taken. The phi direction is in this direction. All the directions are mentioned clearly in the figure. So you need to draw this figure where you have two point sources of same amplitude and same phase separated by a distance of d, and they are separated at a d by 2 distance from the center, and between them it is the distance of d. So these parameters will come when you write the equations. So this all these things will be used, and this is the direction of phi where you have to mention that, and this is placed on the array axis. So you write on case one, two isotropic, still so much of things are there to be discussed. Step by step I will discuss this. First complete this figure and then we will proceed further. Two isotropic point sources of same amplitude and phase. So draw that figure. So understand case one properly. You know that case two is a small change. That is, here it is same amplitude, same phase. There it will be same amplitude, opposite phase. That is the small change there. So this small change in equation you can see there. Other than that, it's all the process is almost the same. The pattern also will change. We'll see that one by one. So complete this one. Draw the figure. Thank you. So you can see that the phi direction is in the counterclockwise direction. So complete this figure. So once you complete it, just let me know that we'll proceed further. Draw it properly, and this figure is a must when you write the answer. So you can see one more thing, we'll discuss that. So you can see that the angle phi, as I have told you, the angle phi is measured in counterclockwise direction. This is counterclockwise direction from the positive x-axis. Then at the distance point, a distant point in the direction of phi, the field from source 1. So here you can see that it is drawn towards down. So what you can understand here is, this is source 1. It is retarded by 1 by 2 dr cos phi. This point is very important. Retarded by 1 by 2 dr cos phi. So what you can understand is, the field from source 1, the distinct point in the direction of phi, the field from source 1, this is the field from source 1 that is retarded by 1 by 2 dr, or you can see that it is d by 2. So it is dr by 2 cos phi. This source 1 is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi. But if you see that at source 2, it will be in this direction. So what you can say, it is advanced by dr by 2 cos phi. So this is very important point. Source 1 is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi, and source 2 is advanced by dr by 2 cos phi. What is dr? Where dr is the distance between the source, and it is measured in radians. So between the source, we have already seen the distance is d. So dr is the distance between the source measured in radians. And if you are going with source 1, you have to understand that it is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi. And if you are going with source 2, you should know that it is advanced by dr by 2 cos phi. It is very clearly drawn here. One is retarded, another is advanced. So we'll study few equations, and then we will put all these things in the mathematical form, and we will simplify that further. So So you understand these things carefully. Is that clear till here? Is that clear for all of you till here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you have completed till here. Can I go further? You may be completing it. Okay. You might have drawn the figure. I will just remove that part. You can write down these things. Just listen for 1 minute. That is here. Whatever you have been discussing, we have to put those things in the mathematical form, and we have to simplify that. So let us see that. We have seen that with respect to source 1 and source 2. So we have seen that source 1 is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi, and source 2 is advanced by dr by 2 cos phi. Now what is dr? Dr can be defined as 2 pi d by lambda. That is a standard equation. For that, dr can be represented as 2 pi d by lambda, or it can be written as beta d. What is beta? 2 pi by lambda. So beta is 2 pi by lambda. So dr can be represented as 2 pi d by lambda, or it can also be written as beta d. So the total phase difference. Is there any phase difference for this? What you have studied here? What you have studied? There is same amplitude and phase. So there should not be any phase difference. But let us write the equation for that. The total phase difference can be written with the equation. Psi is equal to dr cos phi plus delta. And delta is called as the initial phase difference. And since it is here, what it is told? Same amplitude and same phase. So delta has to be zero. So psi is equal to dr cos phi plus delta. This delta value need to be zero, because we have written that it is same amplitude and same phase. So since it is same phase, the initial phase difference will be zero. So what will be the equation will get converted as psi is equal to dr cos phi, since delta will be zero. So you complete till here. It's not over. It's a very easy. Few small equations are there to understand, and every student gets full marks if this question comes for them, and they can present it very well. Okay. Only thing is that you should not get confused with case 1 and case 2. That is only problem which some students do it without reading the question carefully. They start writing the answer. So you should see that whether it is same amplitude and same phase in the question paper, then you have to go with case 1. Otherwise, you can see that which case it is same amplitude and different phase. You may be going with case 2 and like that further. So once you all complete till this equation, psi is equal to dr cos phi, and I have told you that delta will be 0 only because of the reason that it is same phase. So equation for dr is, you can write it as 2 pi d by lambda, or you can write it as beta d. And equation for psi is dr cos phi in this case. The general equation for psi is dr cos phi plus delta, and since same phase, delta is 0. So I think all of you might have completed this by this time. Have you all completed?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have seen this figure where the two isotropic point sources were placed at same amplitude and phase. We have also seen that source 1 is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi, and source 2 is advanced by dr by 2 cos phi. dr is the distance between the source measured in radians, and dr is also defined as 2 pi d by lambda, or it is called as beta d. And we have seen that psi can be written as dr cos phi plus delta, and psi is dr cos phi because delta is 0. So why delta is 0? Because of same amplitude and same phase. Because of same phase, delta is 0. Okay, so we have seen all these things. Now let us continue further. So you need to remember the equation for dr, that is 2 pi d by lambda. You need to remember the equation for psi, that is dr cos phi in this case. So just remember these two equations, it will be useful for you further. So moving on further, the phase difference of the wave from point source 1 is minus psi by 2, and from point source 2 is psi by 2. So I am just going to represent in the vector form, and so I can write it as psi by 2 here, and this is retarded by so you can see that what we have studied in the thing, it is dr by 2 cos phi, it is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi source 1 and advanced by dr by 2 cos phi source 2. So what is dr? Dr is beta d or 2 pi d by lambda. So we can write it as in the vector form, that this can be written as psi by 2, and so it is, one is this side, it will come, that is e naught e to the power of minus j psi by 2 for source 1, because it is retarded, and another is advanced, so it will be at this point with positive psi by 2, that is e naught e to the power of j psi by 2. So this we have to write for the total field. You know, all of you know to write that the total field at a large distance r in the direction of phi. This can be converted in the form of an equation. It can be written as E is equal to the combination of both, that is E naught e to the power of minus j psi by 2 plus E naught e to the power of plus j psi by 2. So this equation is very important. We are going to use these equations further. So what you can see, you have seen that the point source 1 is retarded by dr by 2 cos phi. What is dr by 2 cos phi? See here, what is dr cos phi? It is psi. So you can write psi by 2. So that's what I have written, psi by 2, retarded by psi by 2, or dr cos phi by 2. So here it is advanced. So dr by 2 cos phi, or you can write it as psi by 2. Advanced this side, point source 2, and this side it will be point source 1. So when you write the equation combining these things, you will get E is equal to E naught e to the power of minus j psi by 2 plus E naught e to the power of plus j psi by 2. What is psi? Just now we have seen that is dr cos phi. So just now we have written the equation for E. Now it is just the process of simplifying the equation further by substitution of few terms, and we are going to simplify that further. So I can rewrite this equation, E naught e to the power of minus j psi by 2 plus E naught e to the power of plus j psi by 2 as E is equal to 2 E naught e to the power of j psi by 2 plus e to the power of minus j psi by 2 divided by 2. I have rewritten the equation. I have taken 2 E naught outside. Rest of the things I have put it in bracket, e to the power of j psi by 2 plus e to the power of minus j psi by 2 divided by 2. So why I have written, I can convert this in the form of cos. So that's the reason I have written it. So e to the power of j psi by 2 divided plus e to the power of minus j psi by 2 divided by 2 is called as cos psi by 2. So first to complete it, I'll give you some 1 or 2 minutes to complete till day, then I will discuss further. So today we have understood case 1 and it is still going on. So in case 1 we have understood how the field components are placed, how the point sources are placed, and what is the equation for psi and what is the equation for dr. All those things we have understood. We have also written the equation for E, that is E naught e to the power of minus j psi by 2 plus E naught e to the power of plus j psi by 2. We know that we can take 2 e naught outside, or you can rewrite in the form of 2 e naught e to the power of j psi by 2 plus e to the power of minus j psi by 2 divided by 2. So all of you know that this can be represented in the form of e to the power of j psi by 2 plus e to the power of minus j psi by 2 is same by divided by 2 is same as cos of psi by 2. So I have not done too much further here. I just substituted the psi. What is psi? Dr cos phi. So I have substituted psi here. So I can rewrite this equation further by substitution of psi. That is E naught cos dr by 2 cos phi. This component 2 E naught is called as the magnitude component. Cos of dr by 2 cos phi is called as the phase component. So you got the equation for E as 2 E naught by substitution of psi. You got 2 E naught cos dr by 2 cos phi. So this is the magnitude component and this is the phase component. So for normalized value of E, we can, if you are taking the normalized value of E, you can set 2 E naught is equal to 1. Also, assuming the distance between the source D is equal to lambda by 2, we are assuming that the distance between the two sources D is lambda by 2. So when you assume that the distance is lambda by 2, what is dr? Dr is 2 pi d by lambda. So I can substitute D here. So I am going to just substitute dr equation is 2 pi d by lambda, and in place of d I am going to substitute lambda by 2. So when I substitute lambda by 2 here, finally I will get dr is equal to pi. So for normalized value, we can set 2 e naught is equal to 1, and by assuming d is equal to lambda by 2, what we can find out what is dr. Dr is 2 pi d by lambda, and substituting d here in dr, you'll get 2 pi lambda by 2 by lambda, that is same as pi. So what you got, dr is equal to pi and 2 e naught is equal to 1. So let me use these two things in the equation for E, that is 2 e naught cos dr by 2 cos pi. I'm going to put 2 e naught is equal to 1 and dr is equal to pi. So what I will get, cos of pi by 2 cos pi I'll get. Just substitute those two things there. So you'll get substitution. When you do it, you'll get E is equal to cos of pi by 2 cos pi. Here what all things we have taken? We have taken 2 E naught is equal to 1, and we have assumed that the distance between the sources is d lambda by 2. Substituted in the equation for dr, you got pi. Substituted 2 e naught and e, 2 e naught and dr in this equation. So what you have done, you have substituted this here and you have substituted this here. So when you substituted both the things, you got E is equal to cos of pi by 2 cos pi. So it's clear for everyone till here?
Yes,
is that
yes,
clear?
Sir.
Okay, fine. So you make a note of all these things. So this is about the first case, but we have to draw, we have to substitute the angles of phi, like cos 0, cos 90, cos 180, cos 360, cos 270, like that we will be substituting. I will teach you that in the further class, and we'll be drawing a pattern for this. So that is a continuation of this further, and we have to come out with a pattern. So we'll be drawing it at different values of phi here. Cos phi is there, no? So this value phi will keep changing. So that value for different values of phi, that is 0, 90, 270, 360, all those 180, 60, all those values are there. We will see some calculations for E and then plot it in a sheet. I mean, so plot the pattern. So that's we will wind up for here. And all of you have completed till E is equal to cos of pi by 2 cos phi, I think so. So is everything is clear for you? It's clear for all of you? Case
yes,
one
yes,
is
sir.
Clear? Okay, fine. So we will stop it here and we will meet next class. Okay, thank you.